student, this is Preeti More and I welcome you all today's YouTube video. Now in the last video we have completed the chapter 14, the globe, latitudes and longitudes. So the latitudes and the longitudes. What we have covered in that chapter, we have seen the earth, the globe, lines of latitude and heat zone also. We have seen lines of longitude, meridian of longitudes and the longitude and the time. So what is the globe? The globe is a small spherical model of earth, and axis means an imaginary lines which is drawn on the globe and with the center of the earth joining its two pole. Now the longitude is the angular distance of a place north or south of the equator as measured from the center of the earth is called latitudes. Now the longitude is the angular distance of a place east or west of a prime meridian as measured from the center of the earth. Great circle, any circle on the surface of the earth that has its center as the center of the earth. Now what we I told you in the last video, so we have to complete the objective exercise of this lesson of this chapter, because in your first term exam you have two chapters of the geography, 14 and 15. So today we are going to complete the objective exercise of chapter 14, then we'll start our chapter 15 from the geography only. And student, now actually we have completed our English syllabus, so and GE syllabus also of 6th standard. So from today you are only getting the videos of essays, because our essay syllabus is still not completed as mentioned in the syllabus in the 6th standard. So from today you will get till your exam the essays video instead of the English and GE, because the GE and English syllabus we have already completed, but our essay syllabus is still not completed. So first our priority is to complete this syllabus till your exam. Now the first is exercise is there on page number 125, fill in the blanks. So what is there in the fill in the blanks, and this is very important because in the exam there are the question will be from fill in the blanks. So the spelling should be learned by you. Aapko spelling acche se likhna aana chahiye. That's why the objective is very important. In objective if you are writing the fill in the blanks with proper spelling, so you can get the out of marks, right? So you have to more focus on this objective. So what is the first one? The shape of the earth is the best described by the term. I just write on the board answer. The first one's answer is, fill in the blanks. A answer is, the shape of the earth is best described by the term geoid. So the answer is geoid. Now the B number, all lines of latitudes are drawn parallel to the equator. So the B answer is, the B's answer is parallel. So all the lines of the latitudes are drawn parallel to the equator. Now the next one, See, the blank space circle marks the northern limit beyond which there can be the daylight or the darkness for more than 24 hours. So, the circle is, which circle is that? That is the Arctic Circle. The Arctic Circle marks the northern limit beyond which there can be the daylight or the darkness for more than 24 hours. Now D, the prime meridian passes through the British Royal Observatory at Greenwich. So its answer is Greenwich. Now E number, day and blank space change when we cross the international date line. So what will be the answer of E number, day and date? Day and date change when we cross the international date line. So here we have written the answer of question number first, fill in the blanks, and you have to learn the all the spelling of these blank space: geod, parallel, Arctic, Greenwich and date. You have to learn that spelling. If the blank space, if any of the blank space will come in your exam and you are not writing the proper spelling of that, so you will get the zero marks. So it is very important to learn that spelling and write fill in the blanks with proper spelling. So you just note down this of chapter number 14, the globe and the latitudes, question number first, fill in the blanks answer. You note down this in your notebook. Now the next question, question number 2 is, choose the correct answer. The term used to describe the first one, four options are there and we have to choose the correct option. This will be also in your exam. So A number, the term used to describe the true shape of the earth is. Now the four option is there and the first correct option is geoid. The term used to describe the true shape of the earth is geoid. This is the question number 1's answer. And here I am writing the question number 2 answer. So which is the first correct option is geoid. The term used to describe the true shape of the earth is geoid. Geoid is the correct option. Now the second is B, the value of the prime meridian is, the value of the prime meridian is 0 degree. Is 0 degree. There are four options: 0 degree, 90 degree E, 180 degree, 90 degree W. So the answer is the value of the prime meridian is 0 degree. Now see, the torrid zone is the four options are there: the hottest zone, coldest zone, neither hot or nor cold, or moderate zone. So the torrid zone, which is coming in the middle of the earth, equator zone, and there is coming the torrid zone because the sun rays directly fall in the torrid zone and it spread in very less time. So that place is very hot. So the torrid zone is the hottest zone. So option number C A's answer, this is B's answer, and C's answer is hottest zone. Option number first is the correct. Now D, the Arctic Circle lies in the D number, the Arctic Circle lies in the option, four options are there: Northern Hemisphere, Southern Hemisphere, Eastern Hemisphere and Western Hemisphere. So the first one answer is correct, Northern Hemisphere. So D's answer is Northern Hemisphere. Sorry, Northern Hemisphere. Now E number, the value of the Tropic of Capricorn is, the value of Tropic of Capricorn is four options: 23.5 degree and 23.5 degree S, 23.5 degree E, 66.5 degree S. So the option number second is correct. So what is there in the option number second? 23.5 degree S. So these are the correct option which we have chose from the options. So first answers is geoid is the correct option. In the second, in the B number, 0 degree is the correct option. And number in C, the hottest zone is the correct answer. In D, Northern Hemisphere is the correct answer, and E, 23.5 degree S is the correct options. So you just note down this one also in your notebook. You have written these. Now your question number 3 is match the row. So I have to rub these, then let's do the question number 3. So two rows are there. In first row, prime meridian, B, axis of earth, C, Tropic of Cancer, D, international deadline, and E, IST. So we have to match that first row with the second row. So for the prime meridian, so A, prime meridian will match with 0 degree. B, axis of the earth, will match with tilted at 23.5 degree from the vertical. From second row, the first answer, tilted at 23.5 degree from the vertical. Now next, Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer will match with 23.5 degree N. Tropic of Cancer is matching with 23.5 degree N. Now D, international deadline. International deadline will match with longitudes 180. Longitude 180 degree. Now the last E, IST, Indian Standard Time, IST will match with 82.5 degree E. So the prime meridian is 0 degree. B, axis of the earth, tilted at 23.5 degree from the vertical. C, Tropic of Cancer is matching with 23.5 degree. And D, international deadline, it's matching with longitude 180 degree. And IST, Indian Standard Time, is matching with 82.5 degree E. So you just note down this in your notebook. Now the fourth number, write true or false. Correct the false sentence in your notebook. That means which sentence is wrong there, you have to write there why it is wrong. So the first one, first I just rub this. Now let's do the question number 4, write true or false. So what is first one? I write on the board. All lines of latitudes are great circle. All line lines of latitude are great circles. So this sentence is false. This sentence is false because only the equator is a great circle. So this is the false sentence. So we have to correct it. This is false. So the correct is only the equator. Only the equator is a great circle. Great circle. Now the C is B is the Antarctic Circle is located at 66.5 degrees S. So I am not writing B because this is the correct. So it's C and B's answer is it is true. Now C, the international deadline runs mainly through the Pacific Ocean. So this is also true. So the B, the Antarctic Circle is located at 66.5 degrees S. This is true. The C, the international deadline runs mainly through the Pacific Ocean. This is also true. Now the D, the IST is based on 82.5 degrees E. This is also true. Yes, the IST is based on 82.5 degrees E. Now the last one I write E. The world is divided into 36 time zone. Is this true, student? No, this is totally wrong. The world is divided into 24 time zones. So this sentence is false. So let's correct this. The world is divided into 24 time zones. So there are two incorrect. There are two false sentences. The first one A and the last one E. All the lines of latitudes are great circle. This is false because the only the equator is a great circle. Now the E one is, the world is divided into 36 time zones. This is also false, and the right answer is the world is divided into 24 time zones. So you please note down this in your notebook. So here we have completed the objective of chapter 14, the globe and the latitudes. We have completed the question number first, fill in the blanks, and you have written this. Question number 2, choose the correct answer. This one also we have completed today. Question number 3, match the row. This one also we have done. Now question number 4, this one also we have done right now. Now question number 5 and 6 you have provided already, so there is no need to write this. You just have to study about this now, because your exam is from the next week only. So I hope, student, you have got this chapter, you have understood this, the globe, latitudes and longitudes. Now we'll meet soon in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care and thank you.